Good morning, Libby back today with your eviction series. This one's on the subject of partial payments. We are very empathetic to the do-it-yourself landlords, and we understand sometimes, you know, I'll say finances are difficult and you want to get into scenarios where you accept partial payments. You need to understand kind of the big picture repercussions of that, understand your tenant, and understand the resources that are available to help the tenant. We are big advocates here on sending them a list of charitable organizations. It is often so surprising to even other property managers just how much assistance is available. Remember, as a country, we really are trying to prevent homelessness. So funds are allocated through HUD, through housing, for one-time eviction prevention dollars. And those come down through charitable organizations. So when they talk to you about a partial payment because of maybe a difficulty with an automobile, something happened in their life, those are the circumstances that they can go in for this one-time help. They can get back on track. You can be made whole. There's nothing wrong with you wanting to be made whole according to the terms of the lease agreement. And remember that it's not a matter of you picking and choosing which tenants can have an exception and which can't. That's quite frankly a violation of fair housing. So you want to make sure you're applying the same rules across the board and don't get into partial payments. So we're glad you're here. We hope you're back tomorrow. You can subscribe at youtube.com/securepay1. You can go ahead and follow us on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram. And don't forget, if you need to call and there's some question we can help you with, we'd be happy to. 847-431-3300. Thank you.